still, I do everything else that a common man does. And that requires certain kinds of habits, which I'm going to share with you. I've never shared with anyone before. Daily meditation. Every day, I meditate. And I've been doing it for the last 12, 13 years. And I tell you, it's powerful. Why? Because meditation helps you focus your mind into now. What a common person will take 4 hours to do, I can do that in 2 hours or less. That's how efficient I am. I don't have to sleep more than 5 hours because my body doesn't get so tired. People say, where do you get your energy? I said, I meditate. Right? Really, really high-performing habit. And you look at any CEO, from Jeff Bezos to Bill Gates, everybody does that. They need to do this. I have a goal. I want to accomplish something. And every day, I'm going towards that goal. I have a to-do list. I wake up in the morning, I write down, today, these are the 3 things I'm going to accomplish. And unless I accomplish, I'm not watching Netflix. I'm not going on any, you know, entertainment. I have to accomplish these things. Next is giving my 100% attention to one thing or one person at a time. If you notice, ever me talking to a person, my eyes are glued to their eyes. I do not give a damn if there's an elephant walking by or a zebra flying. I am there for you 100%. And that's what meditation teaches you. So be present on any given time. Multitasking is actually inefficient. You try to look at the WhatsApp and watch the TV and try to get things done. What would take you 1 hour would take you 8 hours. I can guarantee you that. It's very inefficient. So do one thing at a time. Saying no to unwanted things. It's a very important thing. We want to be nice and polite and kind. And as a result, we say to yes to friends come like, hey, let's watch a movie and give an exam. Sure, let's watch a movie. Oh, let's go. So welcome to college life. How many of you live in the dorms, in the hostel? Some of you do. So that's a very fun part of hostel life, but it's also a very inefficient part of hostel life, where you get bothered for unknown reasons. So learn to say no to unwanted things. And sometimes those unwanted things could be the beginning of a bad habit. Somebody tells you to drink or eat something or snort something that you know is not good for you. And you can say no. It doesn't matter that you're young or they're seniors. You believe what you believe and you will be respected for it. Trust me when I say that. Every day, now you're in college, of course you will learn. But beyond college, there's also learning. You know, I hardly went to classes, and I shouldn't be saying this, sitting in a college. But I hardly went to classes. I only went like a few days before exams. But what I learned was, outside the classroom, with in student activities, in events like these, when I would hear guest lecturers, know about the future. I still remember in my electrical engineering class, one guy said, the future of light is going to change. These light bulbs are going to all change. And it was a dark auditorium. And he took a little flashlight and put it on my face. I was sitting right in the front. This is called LED. LED is going to take over, and it has taken over. And I was like, wow, that's the future. He said, yes, all cars are going to have these LED lights that are extremely efficient, extremely bright, and extremely small. Right? So things like that about technology, about politics, I was learning. I met President Obama first time in my college. Right? Now you might say, oh, you are in Chicago, we are in Calcutta. Doesn't make a difference. People, you will, today you have more access to people than I did. You know why? Because of LinkedIn, because of Instagram, because of Twitter. You have access to social media. People will actually respond to you if you write to them in a nice way. So learn. Get mentorship. Next is stay away from negative people and negative gossip. Oh my God, those people, especially us Bengalis, do that a lot. Okay, Tanishita, okay, Konashe. Like with that tone. And there it goes. It's all about ye kharab, wo kharab, they're bad, I am the only one who's bothered. And that is horrible. You know what happens? When you gossip about people, say negative things, you get those negative qualities. When you glorify people, talk about their positive qualities, you get those qualities. Because whatever you think about, your subconscious brain processes that and manifests that. How many of you know about law of attraction? Some of you, Book of Secrets, Law of Attraction. It's not true. It's there. Giving back attitude. When I was building my startup, and I was being mentored by millionaires and billionaires, and you ask. You don't have to do anything. But if you become successful, make sure you help the next generation. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing this for my mentors who helped me. Right? It's gratitude. So give back. Today you receive it. Tomorrow when you become, who knows, somebody from this room can become a prime minister. Might become another, you know, Ambani or somebody of that stature. When you become somebody successful, or even the process of becoming successful, try to give back. Try to help others. Trust me when I say this, the law of karma works. It comes back to you beautifully. You never know how. Here's an example. Today, you help somebody with the homework, right? 20 years later, this person is a minister. You call this person. Hey, I'm Munashe, remember me? Of course I remember you, help me with my homework. Or the other way is, they ask you for little notes, I was absent, you're like, no, I'm not going to help you. 20 years later, you find out there's somebody big, you call them. Remember me? Of course I remember you. Boom. That's the difference. So what you do today counts for the rest of your life. People will remember how you made them feel. So give back. And reward yourself. Be nice to yourself. We have a very, very toxic process of saying, oh, we look at the mirror and say, you're ugly. You're not so smart. You're not intelligent. You cannot speak English properly. You cannot do this. You cannot do that. It's like if it was physical injury, let's say you were hurt, there was a little blood coming out. Would you take a saw and start cutting your finger? No, right? We do that to our emotional injury. Somebody says something hurtful, and we go in the bathroom, look at the mirror, and call ourselves bad things, making it worse, and that's horrible. So please, love yourself and reward yourself every day. Tell yourself that you are somebody special, because you've come from somebody special. Your source and my source is the same. I call that source Krishna. So we are all spiritual beings having a human experience. Understand that this table cannot feel anything. I can crack jokes with Siri on my iPhone, but I know Siri doesn't feel anything. Humans do. And that's why they're tuned to WhatsApp and Facebook. There's a difference between humans and machines. We are conscious beings and we are special. And that means we have unlimited potential if we really truly understand it. Small changes. Now, how do you get these habits? How do you form these habits? One might be like, "Aaj ke change ho everything. Everything changes from today onwards." And we try to lose weight, we do our New Year's resolution, 1st January, 2nd January, 5th January, 10th January, bobbing up.